there, and it's a cold, rainy day here in Tokyo. Yeah, it's a good day to stay inside. All right, so yeah, first one is this lady, and I'm a trading. This album came out in 1978, and it's quite good. It's called To The Limit. Yeah, she's kind of a rock musician. Country rock, blues rock, a little bit jazz, sometimes reggae. She's hard to categorize, but yeah, she's classed on Wikipedia as pop. I've always loved her, you know, like she's probably one of my favorite singers, women singers. I like her voice. She's British, so you know, she's hasn't got all the hang-ups like the Americans have. You know, British people are a little bit more sort of easygoing. I really like the pictures all over the record. Apparently she had it was the first time a woman photographer had ever photoed her, and the woman stayed at her house for 4 days and took a whole bunch of photos to sort of capture her in her apartment and her studio. So the photos are really good. As you can hear, it sounds a little bit sort of like I don't know, classic rock, 70s classic rock, Eagles, Eric Clapton, David Bowie, Frank Zappa. So her producer, he'd actually produced Eric Clapton and the Kinks 70s albums, so it's sort of interesting. So the next couple are Michael Schenker. This is the one I'll look at first. I was reading on Wikipedia, it was very expensive to make this album. Apparently the producer was quite fussy with sort of the production values, and he actually spent a lot of money, which sort of really hurt the band. The band were in debt for quite a while. So anyway, yeah, this one's called MSG, and it goes straight into the song Are You Ready to Rock. Live versions of these songs are pretty well known too. Gary Barton, you know, I always thought he would have been a good Bon Scott replacement for AC/DC. Inside, it's pretty well packaged for Japan, so you got a whole lot of information in Japanese there. And then you got the, it's sort of like black and white, but it's sort of done with color. So, yeah, all the lyrics to the band for those songs, and you know, all the thank yous and stuff like that. It's pretty well packaged, you know, it's nice 80s. Black and white's sort of unusual for the 80s, you know, they loved their color back then. Assault Attack, and they got in Graham Bonnet. So, you know, Graham Bonnet was a pretty well-known singer, and also, you know, he'd sung for Rainbow too. A little bit more intense way of singing, a little bit more sort of operatic. Graham Bonnet always has like his voice doubled a fair bit, especially in the choruses. But yeah, Assault Attack, Rock You to the Ground. It's got the song Dancer, Samurai. So it's very sort of interesting songs. Side 2, Desert Song, Broken Promises. A lot of great songs on here. Produced and engineered by Martin Birch. So you know, he'd just done Number of the Beast, Iron Maiden. This was his next album that he produced. Yeah, he's a great guitarist, you know, everything he sort of does sort of becomes golden. He's still around now, still healthy. So that's Schenker. Alright, the next one's a little bit different. Neil Schon, so he's from Journey guitarist. And you've got Jan Hammer. I don't know if it's Jan or Jan. But, so it's sort of like an unusual pairing of musicians, and then the cover's pretty cool. Untold Passion. It'd been just after this album, he started the Miami Vice soundtracks, you know, for the regular TV show, which was 6 or 7 seasons. That's what he's really famous for. But in the 70s, he was kind of, sort of like a jazz, rock, classic rock musician. And then, you know, Neil Schon was pretty famous with Journey, sort of progressive rock, stadium rock. So yeah, pretty interesting album, like they got together and did this one. can kind of hear it. It sort of like sounds a little bit sort of on the edges of heavy metal. Radio friendly heavy metal. And then you got, you know, Hammer's sort of keyboard coming in with it, dueling with the Neil Schon's lead guitar. So yeah, it's sort of interesting, pretty unusual looking guys, really. Bonnie Tyler, Faster Than the Speed of Night. So, you know, it's sort of a bit of a play on words there. It's got a sort of iconic album cover with a light there. And then even the back cover's pretty mysterious. Album came out in 1983, so it was up against Michael Jackson and everything like that. Straight away, it's a Creedence Clearwater cover, Have You Ever Seen the Rain? So the album consists of dramatically reworked cover songs. Creedence, Blue Oyster Cult songs on there, Gone Through the Motions from 77. Straight From the Heart. I think Straight From the Heart is a Blue Oyster Cult song too. Oh no, a Bryan Adams song. It's a pretty good version of Have You Ever Seen the Rain. I like this version. It also includes the song Take Me Back, written by Billy Cross, a former Bob Dylan guitarist. So that's interesting. Her really famous song is Total Eclipse of the Heart. That's at the end of side one. Alright, now the next album is quite different. It's Chet Atkins, like a jazz guitarist, rockabilly, sort of done everything. Bop. But in the 80s, he sort of reinvented himself. He died about 2001, but yeah, the reason I got this album is I just love the cover. Like, I love that sort of, I love that kind of cover. It's like amazing. I'd have that on the wall. And then on the back, you know, he's sort of getting old, but I like that sort of pixelated photo he used. He really made it sort of the 80s kind of, gave it the 80s polish. So he's a pretty famous sort of jazz guitarist, and you know, he's written a lot of hits for people. But you can kind of hear that he was a little bit of out of touch as far as 80s music went. Sounds a little bit like sort of elevator music or even TV soundtrack kind of music. I'm not saying I don't like it, you know, I like it for what it is, but yeah, it's his 53rd studio album, can you believe that? Released in 1986. It's a very sort of, you know, that Miami Vice era. Very sort of easygoing. Apparently he was going through a country, new age, jazz time of his life in the 80s. So, you know, he had like sort of unusual effects on his guitar, like a little bit heavily processed, and the sort of that synthy poppy keyboard. I kind of like the sort of keys, you know, like the keys that blend in with each other. I don't really sort of like synth when it's played like just key by key, but it still sounds good. Reception, AllMusic critic wrote of the album, this 1986 album has a production sheen to it that makes it totally of its time. It doesn't necessarily wear too well though, because of that. Sounds a bit cheesy. Too many synthesizers and contemporary touches, so probably that bass doesn't help. Simply detract from the main reason you bought it, to hear Chet Atkins play the guitar. Alright, so I've just got two more to go. The Monsters of Rock 1980 official album. And it was, Monsters of Rock was a pretty big festival that used to happen every, I think, year in England. And a lot of bands, you know, sort of got their starts, you know, like a lot of new wave British metal kind of bands got their start. Monsters of Rock. But yeah, if you like heavy metal, you know, it's a pretty famous cover there. Rainbow, the headliners. with Graham Bonnet singing, that's great. Scorpions, April Wine, they were pretty big back then. Saxon, Riot Touch. So it goes straight into Stargazer, a rainbow song, but you got Graham Bonnet singing. So a lot of like purists hated this version of it, but I like it. Yeah, you got some really good shots of the performance on the back there. And inside, just Japanese information, I think. It's all Japanese, no pictures. But yeah, you got the English lyrics there, that's good. Apparently Judas Priest were at this concert, but they're not actually on this album, that's a pity. They probably would have been headliners maybe back then. Would have been the British Steel tour. So the last one. Anthem, one of my favorite Japanese heavy metal bands. First or second one that they released. So it was probably connected to their first album. Yes, that's Normal Speed. It's a great cover. I love that cover. So, you know, there were no sort of restrictions in Japan, sort of regarding sort of sex or violence. Inside you've got, it's pretty much all Japanese, just the album, information and the band. But you've got actual English lyrics, which are really good. That's really good. It's only got 5 songs. Yeah, Australia and I knew these guys late 80s, and I've always loved them. You know, they sort of, they do everything that all the big heavy metal bands do, but just a little bit better and faster and heavier. But yeah, it sort of really reminds me of Judas Priest, Iron Maiden having a baby in Japan. It has something like this. But yeah, they were a great band. Yeah, it was actually, their management is classed as Shibuya. So it's not far from right here. It'd be amazing. Yeah, that's a pretty good one today. All right then, take it easy.